All right, so we're going to go through the process of creating an assignment or a quiz using Google Forms. We're even going to talk about how you can make self-grading assignments and quizzes as well. So we're going to start in Google Drive and try to go ahead and have whatever folder you want this form to exist in. So I have created a new folder called Forms, and then I'm going to click New. Go down to where it says More, and there you're going to see your option for Google Forms. So let's make this a math test. So description there. Make sure also that you click up here and name this whatever you want it to be. So math test one. So first question. Now, by default, it's on multiple choice right now, which is what I recommend, but you can have other options as well for your answer scheme. We'll talk about those in a bit. So, can add as many answer possibilities if you would like. I suggest go ahead and clicking required. Make those students try to answer each question, but that is up to you. Click the plus button here, and we're going to add another question. I can just go down through here and add my own options. Sometimes you get this add all options, which is nice. It's trying to eliminate a little bit of work for you. I'm gonna make this required. Another question. Now, let's just go ahead and have a text answer question. This is maybe not a good question for a math test, but who is your favorite teacher? And then it's obviously detecting that it thinks it should be a short answer. You could use any other of these answer possibilities as well. Require. Now let's just say that this is all the questions I want for my assignment or for my test. Let's go up and tweak a couple of settings now. So we're going to go up here to this gear icon, the settings. Now, on the general tab here, I would go ahead and select collect email addresses. That way you know which student is connected with each response or each form that is submitted. You can also make the first question the student's name as well, but I will generally always add collect email addresses. Also, if this is an assignment, generally you want to limit to one response. Also, you have the option to give the students the ability to go back and edit the form after they have hit submit. If this is a quiz, most likely you are not wanting to click that. Now, let's go over to quizzes. Let's make this into a quiz. Now, one option here to look at is as we make this a quiz, we can make it self-grading. So you can give students the ability to see their grade immediately after they click submit, or you can click later after manual review. You would definitely want to use this later after manual review if there's any discrepancies or opportunity for discrepancies in student answers. Click Save here. Now, as we go back and look at our questions, click on each one. You're going to notice now at the bottom it says Answer Key. So if you click on that, you can now tell Google Forms what the correct answer is. And then you can also specify how many points the question is worth. And also provide answer feedback if you wish to do so. Now, on your short answer questions, you can give multiple answers that would be marked as correct. And if a student exactly inputs the same responses, it will be entered as correct. Now, you can check this right here, and that would mean that any other possible answer would be marked as incorrect. If you leave this unchecked, though, as you're going through and looking at the responses, if somebody were to leave a response other than these, you would have the option to say if it was correct or incorrect, and even give partial credit. You can specify exactly how many points that you would like to award them. So there's my simple test so far. Now, at this point, you could hit send here and a variety of methods for sharing this with your students. But what I would generally suggest you do is always go through and preview your form. Let's go through and let's just take the test ourselves. We're having a bad day, so we're going to miss that one. And we're going to miss this one because I want you to see what this looks like. Yeah. Now, I'm going to go back to the original form, and now you're going to see a responses tab. And there's the number one because we have received one response to this quiz. So there's lots of ways that you can break up the information from your various students' quizzes. You can see a summary. This is a very boring summary because there's only one response. You can see a breakdown question by question. So you would see all the students' responses for each question. So question one, question two, question three. You can also click on individual and you can go through one student at a time and see how they answered each question. I'm going to go back to question because we had that short answer question. So right here you can see this is one ungraded response because Google Forms didn't know that as a possible answer. So it's asking me, is this correct? Is it incorrect? So you can choose that it is incorrect or correct. Now we're going to mark this as incorrect. Let's go ahead and just give this student a few points here. As you can see, you can award any number of points up to your maximum, and then make sure you go down and click save. Get that out of the way there. And we are saved. Google Forms is a great way to provide assignments, especially self-grading assignments for your students. Definitely give it a shot. Doesn't hurt just to get in, start creating a form, and just see what can you do with Google Forms.